Hi everybody, in this video I'm going to show you how to locally debug your Lambda functions using VS Code. Up until this point I've given tutorials using the UI in AWS console, but you don't need to keep doing this. For beginners, this was just to learn the basics of AWS, but as you move further on in your AWS journey, you'll realize it's nice to test your code before you deploy it. So let's get started. Here I have an empty folder in Visual Studio Code opened. It's called local debug AWS Lambda because that's what we're doing. The first thing we need to do is install the AWS Toolkit. I have this installed, it's right here. You can see the little icon, but if you don't have it installed, go to your extensions and type in AWS, and there's the AWS Toolkit, and you can click install. It will show install instead of uninstall right here. The next thing that you need to do is have the SAM CLI installed. You can check if you have SAM CLI already set up. On Windows, it's Control Shift P, which opens the command prompt, or Command Shift P on a Mac. So if you open the command prompt, you can type in AWS detect SAM CLI. You can detect if it's there, and it'll show that I don't have any settings necessary to change. But if you do not have it set up, you will get a prompt to install the SAM CLI. And this will bring you to AWS's walkthrough to install the AWS SAM CLI. Choose the version for your operating system and walk through it. So in my case, I was on Windows. You do not need to do step one and two for the local debugging right now, but you need to install Docker. We need to have Docker installed in order to debug locally. This is because when debugging a Lambda function, the Lambda environment is simulated by spinning up a Docker container. So make sure that you install Docker as well. Also make sure that you have visualization enabled in your BIOS for Docker. And if you're using a Windows machine, you also need to enable file sharing on Docker. After you install Docker, you would go to your settings. And then if you go under resources, file sharing, add the drive. So in my case, I need to make sure that they can access the F drive. And I just gave it to everything on my drive. This is a non-production machine, so that's why I'm okay with giving it everything. But if you're doing this on a more production-oriented computer, you would not give a blanketed everything on the drive. So keep that in mind. We're doing this all local debugging. We're not too worried about those securities, but when you are installing Docker on a production server, you're not going to do this. So once you've installed the SAM CLI and you've installed Docker, make sure that you enable file sharing if you're on Windows 10, and then come back here. So before we just get started, let's check that SAM. Our SAM CLI is enabled and Docker is also available. So go to our terminal and we can type in sam --version. And you should get back the SAM version. So in this case, I have 0.53.0. So this is the SAM CLI version. We know it's installed. The other thing we want to do is docker --version. And our Docker version is available there. Now that we have this set up, let's create a new SAM application. Let's start our command palette. And we are going to write AWS create new SAM application. And now it's going to ask us the runtime version. We're going to do Node.js. And we're going to have a simple SAM app. And this is going to be the Hello World SAM app. And it's going to go inside my local debug AWS. You could select a different folder and then it'll be added to your VS Code workspace. And now our app has been created. And as you can see, this is template.yaml. And inside the YAML, we have our Hello World function and it has an API set up for us. So here's the type, it's AWS serverless function, its properties, the URI, what the handler is, the runtime environment, we chose Node.js. And then here is our API set up with its path to be hello and the method is get. This will actually create an API gateway for us and tie that gateway to the Lambda function. So now let's look at the code. So if we expand Hello World, this is the app.js code. Now I'm being highlighted with a couple of problems because I have JS lint on my machine. So the linter is going through and letting me know that there are certain things that it doesn't like. You might not see the JS linter if you do not have that installed. But right above our exports.lambda handler, we have run locally, debug locally, and configure. This is actually AWS integrating with in Visual Studio Code, and it gives us the ability to be able to debug locally. But before we can start, we need to actually configure our test. So let's click configure. So when you click configure, there's going to be a new folder created .aws. Inside that, it's going to generate a templates.json. So this is a template for our template.yaml. It has the handler and then our Lambda function. And now what we need to generate is the event so that it looks like an API event. Basically, what we're going to do is invoke Lambda with an event source. This is our event source. But right now our event is empty, so we need to use the SAM CLI to generate the event. So in the terminal, let's type SAM, and then what we want to do is do a local generate event. We're generating an event. We're generating a local event from API gateway using AWS-proxy. So this outprints to our terminal something that you can copy. Now it's a lot to copy, so I'm going to show you a little trick here. If we hit our up arrow, so this is the same thing that we did earlier. If you do a pipe, now I am on Windows. So on Windows, what I'm going to type in is clip. So this means that it's going to copy to my clipboard. If you are on a Mac, you would do pipe pb copy. If you're on Linux, pipe xclip. So now I'm going to generate that event and it's copied to my clipboard. So I am going to paste over this event. I don't need these little brackets. So paste. This is my new event. If I want to, I can reformat this file because it's now kind of went a little crazy. Right click, format changes, and you saw the shortcut list Shift Alt. So now we have an event that looks like something that would come from AWS API Gateway to our Lambda function. So now we can debug our Lambda function locally. So I'm going to save this template and going back to our app.js. So in this case, what we want to do is debug our Lambda function locally. We can add a breakpoint. So when you add a breakpoint, you go behind the line number, and that's how you can add the breakpoint. And now let's click debug locally. So a Docker environment is going to be spun up, like I mentioned earlier, to simulate the Lambda environment. If you get errors when you're starting up this command and you have installed Docker, you probably have not enabled sharing if you're on your Windows machine. So make sure that your sharing is enabled. So continue through. We land it on our response equals, and you can investigate your variables. So if I hover over event, you can see this is the event that is coming in. This is actually the generated event. We have our headers and our path and our resources. So this helps us now be able to debug locally. So congratulations, you learned how to debug your own AWS Lambda functions locally. Happy debugging. If you liked what you saw, please subscribe to my channel for more AWS tutorials and other tutorials as well.